The current COVID-19 pandemic has led to most of us being stuck at home. From gaming to home workouts, our options may have already been exhausted from having to keep our attention from the pandemic and negative news surrounding it. The best thing to release all stress is to watch Canada's best TV shows. Let's talk about them today. Welcome to the Aurora Show, home to everything Canadian. In every video, we always bring something enjoyable to you. If you want to be part of the vast entertainment world, make sure to subscribe to the channel. Television has always been a kind of escape. To some, it is an open window to the world. This list will help you narrow down your options because it contains the 10 best Canadian TV shows to binge watch. Without further ado, here are 10 of Canada's best television shows. Number 10, Heartland. Heartland is a CBC TV drama based on the book series of Lauren Brooke. In the book series of the same title, the plot spins around the Fleming family as they deal with the death of their mother. The story is set in the fictional country town of Hudson, Alberta, and many scenes are filmed with the Rocky Mountains as the main backdrop. Watching the series can provide you a sneak peek into the beauty of Alberta's foothills and skyline. The TV series' wholesome and family-friendly character remains faithful to that of the best-selling novels. The series began in October 2007, and has since captivated audience for more than 139 episodes. Having been renewed for its 14th season, Heartland is presently the longest-running scripted TV show in Canadian TV history. Number 9. Can You Hear Me? No list of the best Canadian TV shows would be complete without some francophone representation. Can You Hear Me follows the lives of three adolescents, Ada by Florence Longpre, Carol Ann by Eve Landry, and Fabiola by Melissa Bedard. The story is set in a fictional low-income neighborhood in the city of Montreal, Quebec. The assembly of characters and the series setting portrayals of daily life struggles are relatable to most of its viewers. Since it was on screen in December 2018, this series strikes the right balance between comedy and drama. Can You Hear Me is well-written and well-casted. For these reasons, the series is up for its third season sometime in 2021. Number 8. Travelers. Take time travel, then include a group of individuals who have met by chance. Take the result of this combination and put it in the distant future. What do you end up with? Travelers set in a far-off dystopian future where human society is on the slope of collapse and destruction. Operatives known as Travelers have the impossible task of going back hundreds of years into the past and fixing events that have led to the present state of the world from which they came. Traveling back to the past, a group of individuals learns to use the 21st century tools known to us today. Most heroes go back in time by planting their awareness into a body that lives in the 21st century. It leads them to the lives, jobs, and relationships of the bodies they have assimilated into. These elements make for a dark and compelling science fiction thriller, commendable of your Netflix binge. Travelers is currently on its third season and is available on Netflix. Number 7, Between. Here is another science fiction head-turner from the incredible White North. In a little town called Pretty Lake, there's an outbreak of a mysterious disease. Few people knew about this illness, but it proceeds to bring about the deaths of those who are 22 years old. It leaves Pretty Lake in a situation where many have died and only a few remain. As the entire town is quarantined, the last remaining residents are left to fend for themselves. During the panic and chaos, the daughter of a pregnant minister played by Jeanette McCurdy fights to survive the chaos and the disarray her rural town has been left in. Between has all the elements of a grasping, dark, and ominous thriller, a la The Walking Dead and Lost. Filled with various plot turns and cliffhangers, it will leave you at the edge of your seat with every episode. Number 6, Alias Grace. Alias Grace is based upon the Margaret Atwood novel of the same title. CBC publicized premiere on September 24, 2017. Months after that, the series became available on Netflix. Based on Atwood's 1997 novel, Alias Elegance highlights Beauty Mark's life, the lady connected to the real-life murders of Thomas Kinnear and Nancy Montgomery. More than just an entertaining miniseries, Alias Grace can give you an idea of how mental health was viewed socially in the mid-1800s. Giving a premise for comparison to Canada's current mental health care model, Alias Grace permits you to see how distant mental health in Canada has gone from a model based on institutionalization to one based on care and conveyance. The on-screen portrayal of this underlying social commentary might be what you are looking for if you have not yet read the novel. Friends, I hope you've enjoyed the video so far. Don't forget to subscribe to The Aurora Show. And if we've missed any important spots in the list so far, tell us in the comments below. Your thoughts are important to us. Keep watching. We are moving towards our fifth best Canadian TV show. Number 5, Frontier. Probably one of the best or overlooked parts of Canadian history is the North American fur trade. Frontier is set during the 18th century and follows Declan Harp's exploits by Jason Momoa, a half-Irish, half-Cree outlaw. Declan Harp is on a quest to destroy the monopoly of fur by the Hudson Bay Company. To further its own financial and political interests through the fur trade, the company resorts to illegal activities. It is precisely what the outlaw Declan Harp wishes to stand in the way of. The series was co-produced by Discovery Canada and Netflix. For this reason, Frontier is available on Netflix for all 3 seasons. Number 4, Schitts Creek. Schitts Creek is a comedic falling from grace portrayal of a family who loses all its fortune and status. Schitts Creek follows the life of the Rose family, a family that has made a fortune in the video industry, but after enjoying a long life of privilege, the family abruptly finds itself bankrupt. This terrible turn of events has brought many painful life changes and hard decisions to all of the family members. One of these decisions is a move to the town of Schitts Creek, where the family moves into a rundown motel. Though this might sound like the preview of a sob story, the conflict engendered by the locals' lifestyle and the family creates numerous situations that will have you on the floor laughing. Besides this, these circumstances eventually end up providing the change necessary for the family to work out issues caused by a life of privilege and affluence. Groundbreaking in media, this Canadian sitcom won more than 18 Canadian Screen Awards and 2 ACTRA awards. Number 3, Anne with an E. This on-screen adaptation comes in the form of Anne with an E. Through a series of fortunate events, Anne Shirley, played by Amy Beth McNulty, is adopted by siblings Marilla, played by Geraldine James, and Matthew Cuthbert, played by R.H. Thompson. Anne finds a new family in the Cuthberts, the proprietors of Green Gables. Creative and nothing shy of voluble, Anne goes through the usual childhood experiences of school and puberty, all while trying to separate her ties with her traumatic past. The series received a 91% audience score from Rotten Tomatoes. Anne with an E is also the recipient of the highly coveted Canadian Screen Award for Best Dramatic Series 2 years in a row. Anne with an E is also the recipient of the highly coveted Canadian Screen Award for Best Dramatic Series 2 years in a row in 2017 and 2018. Number 2, Trailer Park Boys. For many, a series is worth binge-watching when it has more than 10 seasons. Trailer Park Boys currently has all 12 seasons available on Netflix. If you are in the mood for some giggling humor set in Nova Scotia, be prepared to binge for an entire weekend. Trailer Park Boys is a TV show in style resembling that of a reality show. It follows the lives of the residents of a fictional trailer park known as Sunnyvale Trailer Park. In contrast, the show has more than 10 recurrent characters. 3 supply most of the show's humor. All through the series, changes happen, including Ricky's new role as a grandfather and Jim LaHaye's sobriety, albeit temporary. The resulting sequence of incidents and misadventures will set you off into tears, not from sadness, but from giggling your lungs out. Prepare for 12 seasons of utter hilarity brought to you by the kind folks of Sunnyvale Trailer Park. Number 1, Kim's Convenience. Topping this list is a Canadian sitcom that has both delighted viewers and given Asian representation. Kim's Convenience has taken its viewers into the lives of a Korean-Canadian family who run an eponymous convenience store. The series follows the lives of Appa, Uma, Janet, and Jung. As immigrants, Appa and Uma balance exploring Toronto's trade scene and being parents. Being exceptionally traditional in their child rearing, both tend to gush on Janet's personal life and chosen career path. At the start of the series, it becomes clear that Jung and Appa have a difficult relationship that becomes challenging later on. Kim's Convenience is filled with scenes where Appa and Uma attempt to make sense of the foreign, new environment, which is obvious as early as the first scene of the first season. With 4 seasons available on Netflix, Kim's Convenience is a must for anybody who enjoys a wholesome giggle. Who speaks to your tastes? Do not forget to tell us in the comments below. Feel free to take in the beauty of Canada's surroundings as they appear on screen. That's all for today. I hope you enjoyed our list. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel to watch more entertaining videos in the future. See you next time!